Now on ESPN 8, The Ocho, bringing you the finest and seldom seen sports from around the globe since 1999. If it's almost a sport, we've got it here.
Welcome to another episode of SGFFL Today. I'm the host, the Commish. Well, we enter week three of the regular season. Two teams still undefeated, a couple teams still looking to get that first win of the season or to get over 500. Let's take a look at what's going on right now with a early season assessment. Let's go to the pit with one of you, one of the owners. Here's Jason Gross. Jason?
Looking at the league this year, I think we got some powerhouses like the Hillman Chiefs. The Hillman Chiefs are on top of their game and scored 84 points last week. They really rolled in the 13. Skippyville is coming around. I can't believe that after a few years in the doghouse. Scott City is 4-0. He looks really good this week. This week he's got Big D's Dynasty. That should be a great matchup for him and his team. I myself have a good team. I can't believe that.
Thank you, Jason. We've heard about some of the teams that are doing quite well this year, but let's focus now on a few teams that are not doing so well. Jason, who's not doing well in your eyes, and what do they need to do to turn it around?
Lastrup is really in the doghouse. I think he's dug a hole about 6 feet under. But other than that, everybody's got great competition. Hurt Locker, I think, might come around at the end of the season too, and he's always got good vibes of his fantasy football. And otherwise, other than that, I think we're gonna have a good season.
And before we go, let's spotlight one more owner. Willie Hansen with the Boston Steamers had 3 first round picks. In this league, it doesn't matter how many high picks you have, it matters what you do with them. Willie traded up to get the number one overall pick, drafted Adrian Peterson, who is now on the shelf for the rest of the year. Last year, if you remember, Willie also took Eddie Lacy number 4 overall. Does Willie have the opposite of the Midas touch? Jason, back to you. What can you tell us about poor Willie Hansen?
I thought he was going to be a powerhouse, but yet he's still in the doghouse. After having 3 first-round picks, AP goes down. He's just not having the best of season again. I do believe he's 1-3 again. I think he'll, within the next couple weeks, he'll have a fire sale and try and get as many first round picks as he can. It's just, I don't know what to say.
Thank you, Jason. This has been the SGFFL Today. I am your host, The Commish. And as always, study hard and play even harder. We'll see you soon.
I just gotta say one more thing. I gotta say this league is a very great league to be in. I've been in it for now, I think 15 years now. I've won it in 2003, 2006, 2009. I think Scott Gross really puts together a great league. And the team members are always really great to know. The Hurt Locker came in here like 3-4 years ago, and he started making noise right away, and we didn't know what to think about him, but he's a great, knowledgeable fantasy football guru. We got a few new guys in here. We don't know what to expect from them, but I think they'll do great also, but it's a very fun league. I think Scott Gross does a lot to put this league together, and we all appreciate that, and we do think that it's a lot of work and time put into his day, and we just gotta thank him, and that we can have 20 people all on the same page playing football together in our fantasy dreams. I just gotta put that in there. Thanks a lot, buddy. Living like a renegade, renegade.